Robert Salas served 7 years in the Air Force, rising to the rank of captain.
So tell me what happened.
March 24, 1967, I and my commander, Fred Miwal, were on duty in Roy, Montana.
The men are stationed in the missile launch bunker, 20 meters below ground.
We had control of 10 nuclear missiles. The Minuteman won. Each missile had an 800 kiloton nuclear weapon.
If ordered, it's Salas's job to launch the warheads.
I was on alert status. In other words, my commander, Fred, was taking a little nap break. Sometime in the early morning hours, I get a call.
Salas.
Is a terrified guard stationed above the bunker.
He's screaming into the phone. He's yelling, "Sir, I'm looking out the front gate. I see this glowing red object."
The strange red object is moving like nothing the guards have ever seen before.
They're flying very fast across the sky, stopping on a dime, reversing course, making 90-degree angle turns, making no noise. These guys were very, very frightened. It was a critical situation.
As fear spreads above ground, things were about to get even more terrifying below.
I need you to wake up. I've got the weirdest phone call.
Salas wakes his commander and tells him the guard's report of a UFO above the base. Suddenly, the unthinkable happens.
The lights turned from green to red. In other words, red meaning unlaunchable.
Everything went red.
All 10 missiles were disabled, every single one of them.
So what does that mean?
It means if we were given the order and if we had to go through our launch procedures, they couldn't be launched. This was an inexplicable situation.
With the missiles down, America's nuclear shield is compromised.
What was going through your mind when all this was happening?
You know, I'm thinking we're under some sort of an attack.
As Salas and his commander desperately try to get their missiles back online, they're told that a week earlier, another missile launch crew at Malmstrom Base reports seeing the same strange lights. And seconds later, their nuclear warheads also go offline.
All 10 of their missiles went down while a UFO was overhead. All 10 of our missiles went down, UFO was immediately over our facility.
What did you think when you found out that this had happened not once, but twice?
These were the most sophisticated weapons we had, and so it was worrying that something very unknown, very unusual, very strange could disable them.
Is this a coordinated attack by the same unidentified craft?
Give us a reading on each one of them!
In both cases, the weapons are out of action for nearly 24 hours.
We did our chance. There's no way!
So what did shut down the nuclear missiles at Malmstrom Air Base, and why?
This was extraterrestrial in nature. I honestly believe that.
Former head of the UK government's official X-Files is searching for hard evidence that UFOs are targeting nuclear bases. Nick has been gathering evidence about a terrifying incident with a potential UFO above a nuclear base in Montana.
I'm thinking we're under some sort of an attack.
But are these strange lights really UFOs? Or could there be a more logical explanation? The incident at Malmstrom happened in 1967, just 5 years after the Cuban Missile Crisis, when the US is on high alert.
We were on a hair trigger with the Soviet bloc, so it was a critical situation international-wise.
Could these lights have been some Soviet aircraft or drone?
Absolutely not. All aircraft that I know of
make some sort of a sound and have some sort of a propulsion system that we can explain. Nothing like that. And by the way, I worked for Federal Aviation Administration in aircraft structures for 22 some years. So I think I know my aircraft.
So if this isn't a hostile act by a foreign power, what are the strange lights in the sky? And are they the cause of the missile shutdown? This video is filmed in Montana, relatively close to the Marstrom Air Force Base. It shows the aurora borealis, or northern lights. The aurora are caused when particles flying off the sun strike the gases in our atmosphere, causing them to glow. Could this natural phenomena account for the strange lights the guards described seeing that night? If it does, could it also explain why the missile shut down?
The aurora is actually an electric current system flowing through our sky just above us. Those currents can actually come and flow through the power grid system here on Earth. And when they flow through that power grid, they can cause damage anywhere from brownouts to temporary flickering or even fires in transformer stations that cause permanent damage.
Do you think this could have explained what happened to the missiles?
No. The aurora borealis is seen from those northern tier states, Montana. But the airmen up top, they had been there for years, so I don't see how they could have mistaken the aurora borealis for this object hovering above the front gate, or why the aurora borealis would have frightened them. I want to emphasize that we did not lose electrical power at all during this incident. There would have been other effects besides just the missile shutting down. We would have had electrical effects on our electrical systems. We had no problems with the electrical systems.
So if the aurora isn't responsible for shutting down the missiles, what is? Could computer failure be the cause? A team of scientists and engineers analyze every part of the launch computer. Using the Freedom of Information Act, Salah, still haunted by the incident, obtains a copy of the once classified report.
They went through a complete technical evaluation. At the outset, the team quickly noticed there were no significant failures that would explain how 10 missiles were knocked off alert. This kind of event is virtually impossible once the system was up and running. This was a grave concern to their command, that they could not explain, and the Air Force could not explain, the contractors could not explain why these incidents happened.
Had anything like this ever happened before in the whole history of the American nuclear force?
Nothing like this even remotely ever happened.
Almost 5 decades later, no official explanation has been given for the shutdown of the 20 nuclear missiles. Salas is in no doubt as to why.
It was most definitely a UFO that shut down our missiles.
If this is true, what do they want with man's most powerful weapons?